bubbly Baptist, which are gay lunatics, actually it's mostly a religion, it's a semblance of Christianity, but it isn't really. And they're mad, and they're killing everybody else. I've seen them murder other people in the church. And in the building, the Basilica, the church actually building is called Basilica, but Christians meet in this castle, but it's Basilica. And they're actually killing everybody, including their own numbers, and they have mass executions and so on. And they actually think that when everybody's dead, Jesus will come and take over. They actually went out, they also have an idea of making a huge animal, playing the whole of the world, killing everybody, so the devil can fly out and Jesus will come. Well, it's absolute garbage, it really is, and they actually believe it. And then one of the wars doing is the people in the power are making money out of this idea, and of course they don't have a good time, what when we die. And that's the whole of Christianity, basically. And the other lot, the Anglicans and Catholics, and so on, and the other lot, and most of them actually have the idea, the same idea. You teach the ordinary people they're immortal, so they work in deaths, in very bad conditions, and as I have. And they get rewarded in heaven, which is not true, they don't get anything, they just die. And they can't come back to reveal to their friends how they've been deceived, because they're dead. And that's on the basis of Christianity. And it goes back far more Christianity. It's a lie. And the people in power, the priests and the rich people, have a good time and have drink wine and have women and nice golden palaces before tomorrow we die. Okay, and that's a part history of civilization. And that goes back at least 8,000 years. It actually dates back to the development of the warrior. The warrior class, they took people's money. They lived by, they're parasites, they lived by others. And under the communists, there was such labour, which caused parasitism, and it was a criminal offence. And it would be nice if that communist idea was brought back, you see. And interestingly, the Christians, the devil himself, they just make money, basically. And die. And before tomorrow we die. That's what every priest believes, everybody knows that. And they put in the mouth and lie. And the gods will say, every time please don't ever come at Christians, open his mouth, the devil flies out. And they scar people's faces. And they do that in order to mark them. So later on they can say all things about them, they do this and that, and then they get attacked. So it's a way of controlling the population. These methods go back a long time. Yes, and they're criminals. So they use training to get people to cover up all their secrets and so on. They get on with it and steal it and murder them. And they're criminals, murderers, thieves, liars, everything. Christians, the devil himself. And they don't realize, they do realize. The ordinary people who believe what they give to the priest, and the ordinary people probably don't, but things are getting worse. And the Pope doesn't lie, basically. He knows. He's a wise man, basically. He's using his position to lie. And he talks a lot about Christianity. He actually wants to balkanize Europe. You can see it in his speech, which it is already. And the original, it was actually balkanized at the end of the Roman Empire in order to protect the Christians. So it's a divide and rule, which is the system. That's how it goes. So the Pope is another lie. And he united Europe, of course, uniting diversity is what he said. It's a good idea, of course, but no one Christianity is a lie. He wants to get control because he gets money out of it all. That's what he does. He's as a man, makes money. What do you call cash? Dosh. It's like you've got dot or done. They're vicious people. Vicious, horrible people, but not all of them insulted. You and I know Christians, so Christians are just ordinary people. The ordinary people in every society are pretty good people. You go abroad, they can look after you, if you're starving, they let you die. You know? They can't afford to support you. And that's wrong. And that's the case of all people who are not in the family, if they're not. It's actually in history as well. Somebody from outside, when they're first with the family, who takes them as wealthy enough, they will support them. But if they can't, they throw them out. Because that means they die as well. And that's the problem. And in other parts of the world, a foreigner coming into the place is actually another hand to the harvest. But until things got bad, so they get thrown out. Yeah. also, Bill's manager actually gave us somebody else coming from the Hungary, which is actually good stuff for having sex with those babies. So that's the human race. So it's been like that forever. And so that is. And somebody scarred me. Well, I don't quite know when it was. It was about money, and money was always money. I think it was an accident. And so on. And they could have done better repairing it, and they didn't. And But it's actually about money. It was actually about money. So they were punishing me for saying what I knew to be true, and they know to be true too. It's always that you get down to it. If you get talk to them long enough, they'll throw it out. Yes, it's probably what it is. And so it's pretty dead of the water. And well, these wars, are pointless. If you say they're doing is not true, they're not to attack you because they're going to die. I feel that they know that. So they feel, you killed them, but it's good to know. And they can't understand that. Civilization of human beings normally is secretly help one another. But when things go bad, they won't. And things go bad, they won't. Things are bad at the moment. And I'm trying to make an engine to replace oil, which I know works, it's been made before. And it does actually work, it produces electricity for air, reaction air, but it's going to deteriorate, maybe deteriorate air as well, So that's a possibility, but it's a neutron blast, so it's going to screw it up, but that's a good thing. But the people who own the oil companies and all that, they don't like it because they lose money. That's more important to them than saving the environment. They talk a lot about the environment, but because it's all a lie. People, you kind of know about this, so people talk to them know about it. And they won't use it because it reduces the income. We're not smoking, Although they lip service in the world, they ban smoking, but, they still do it because it gives much money. Who sells money? And of course, if you all die of cancer, that saves the pension, doesn't it? I don't want to pay pensions because it does cost them money. It's absolutely awful. It really is. And the socialists, it's well meaning, but it doesn't work because the people who implement it don't. That's also wonderful, but the doctors exploit it and charge as much as they can and get a job for life. And that's what ruins society. Private medicine is better, but it's actually cheaper. And I thought at one time that it's been more expensive, but it's actually because they don't have to charge. It's free, and they can charge for that. Obviously, the rich ones they charge for, and probably haven't got anything to this. And so they get themselves. So that means most doctors instinctively help people, but they charge because they have to pay for themselves, and they charge according to their wealth. That's what they charge for. Obvious. So important things to pay out. But if you haven't got the money, no doctor will cut his price. And even in France, I was told. The certificate saying that I was unable to drive because I couldn't see, which is true. I've had visual problems, and I had a nasty accident. No, nobody was hurt, but I cost a lot of money. But I needed that. Well, the original one, the price was so much. I said, I haven't got it. So he said, how much have you got? And he cut the price. He just left the charge. Probably it's like that. It's better. There's an after charge. So it's a good doctor would do that. Good bad doctors kill people. So, and in Hungary, they've got the Nazis there, and they have death camps. That's socialism. It's all socialism. Mr. Wilson's idea was when you reach 65, we don't need you anymore, so we give you a little injection. Old people have a few months and they kill you. And that's the system. That's socialism. So, I used to be a socialist, but I found out. Almost too late, like I do. And that's how it is. And they poisoned me, and I would have got old anyway, but I'm not much older than I believe actually I was shot down in 1942 in Boyne, so I'm not actually human at all, but there it is. So I'm actually much older anyway. And space aliens can generate bodies and so on, but no guarantee I would, of course. And I've actually died several times, so it's very unpleasant. But I wouldn't like to do it again, because it's always the same. Horrible. And you don't expect to go back to the deck, because you do. That's the problem. And one of the Starship's crew's training is to somehow die, which is, but not intentionally, but risk yourself. And if you die, you trust the machine to bring you back to life. That's important. So trusting the machine, trusting the supervisor, that way. And so it is. But we regard ourselves as civilized agents. But you spread civilization around the way, you know, and sentient behavior and so on, sentience. And the thing that makes people civilized is actually self sacrifice for the society, not complete self sacrifice, but a little bit. And the capitalist system is a better way of doing it. It just sounds, when socialism sounds like that, and to respect women, for example, we're not all societies, and women, but a couple more squeezes than women, but they don't all have perhaps stand up really. And there's all sorts of biologies, all sorts of varieties, mostly sexual, but not all this. And Nancy has been gone to church. Nancy in America is probably not that alone. Prison, which is in a world in a tour of a past of the galaxy, and she can tell you about the little planet she's been on. And it's quite interesting what she says, And it's all about biology of different planets, which are not that different from biology either. And there are people who take this sort of thing, it's pretty obvious, space, it's run off in space. But you need education, you have to know things. And there's quite a lot you have to know to sort of understand that. And you also need enough brain to do it. It's not just brain, it's actually what you know. And it's got to be knowledge from good science. And some science isn't good. I mean, even scientists, and so-called scientists, actually cheat and make their things work. And that's why. So if you, a scientist says something works, he has to be challenged severely. Put your face away. Some people do it, it's fatal. But I say this machine works, and I know it does, but I've seen it. And I don't believe it either, particularly because it's so strange. It's very strange when you find you've made something, you spend months working out how to do it, and it works. It's unusual, especially in something like that. And I would always be like that when you try to make something, and you find it works. And you thought it would, but it did. Well, you never believe it until it works. And you're afraid it won't work, And, and I do know it's radioactive. And this transfusion of sleep, Steve called it, was actually, he's actually a skeptic, which is the right thing to be. He's actually producing ozone when it's off. So I don't know whether it's this ozone when you've oxygen or anything. And so I have to short out the transfusion card, resonance card, to stop it from doing anything. And the strongest of it is, and it pushes radiation as well, N-rays. It used to be called, neutral radiation, and it's usually neutral radiation because one of the X-scopes is not charged or discharged by the light of the beams from it. I'm getting old, the poison as well. They wanted me to get old, so I poisoned me before. But the chances of recovery are good. As the stress areas will sort it out. Now I'll be poisoned again everywhere I go. Because it's tired, I get to spit over the house. It's death, you know. Which I could die. That's also, I think, you know, the same thing as sobriety, but I can't tell. I can't tell what's inside me. The doctors are supposed to know, but they don't know. They all sort of say things with the effect it has rather than the truth. And if that's going to die, they'll tell. Which is right. I tell relatives that I think he'd tell a man's going to die next day. He's got all these plans and can't do it. That's true of me. True of everybody. I mean, I know some of those symptoms. And my wife, the Christians say they killed her and dismembered her you're on the moon going, you'll forget me. But I've seen the photograph of the face of the head, and it isn't my wife, so I don't know who she is, who it is. And you might be in some of the other people, somebody else. But my wife is actually, well, it's probably in a Viennese prison, I'm not quite sure. But apparently she wrote me a letter from a railway station on the 14th of the 11th, that's not that long ago. And I sent a letter back. It took me some time. I got it last week, not really, towards the end of last week. And I tried to say, perhaps I should ring them up. I don't know what happened. But I didn't know. They wondered what happened. Apparently she escaped from a prison where the walls are yards thick, and how she got out of work. She walked through a wall quite lightly, actually, because she's actually been, she's died twice, actually. I think I'm not sure what happened. But when she, in Budapest, which is probably back in Budapest, actually, she was actually murdered, executed for murder by brain destruction, as she chose to change destruction. And in Budapest, the death penalty is used, done by beheading, you know. And they do it in public, too. Public executions every day when my last place, Verona. And the psychiatrists, like up here, they destroy the brain, that's what I, which means you're killed. And I want to say to me, well, actually, he said he wanted me to be misidentified as the person who killed his wife on Rumble & Com, which is not true. But that's what I want. And then also, other things that accuse me of all rubbish. And unfortunately, and of course, they know how all the time. It's so evil. It's so evil they murder one of their own people in order to implement their self-vanities. They sacrifice people. And because their delusions are so important to them, that lie is so important to them, they murder and kill. Whatever it is, as I say, so important. And the idea is this wouldn't work if it's a Russian way. It's not true. And it's a tragedy. It's called the tragedy of sentience. We call that tragedy of sentience. Because you're clever enough, they're going to die. And also clever enough, they can't do about it. So, pray, if you like, and do anything like with step being used to die. And Christ is such a quietness as well, you see. Because in only a few hundred years, last day, just as bad. So, I know it's still going to die. No difference. And, we have dreams of violence in their universe, but. And sometimes we find more survivors of what came from previous universe. But we're pretty badly injured, so passing through the universe is extremely difficult. You have to go to orbit around it and so I survive the whatever happens at that time. And some starship commanders or starship crew find God, that's illegal. The reason is not because, well, we've got our Nazis to come and prove, but if they find God, they die. That's what we find. And so it's really. But we do have death ceremonies and so on, which everybody else does. But, you know, because we're all protected by machines, death is rare. But it does happen. If machines go wrong, and we can back up something. If they can go wrong. So the Christians are so evil, they won't kill me for that reason. And so I just for the sake of it, you know, because I've been made to last millions of years, which I obviously got made to, they were going. So obviously that's really nice. And they think, well, I don't think so, they make themselves immortal, and actually, that's what they're killing somebody, it defiles us. But it's the language of the jungle. Because to kill an animal is you eat. And what they're doing the same way. Because while being, we're saying they're not immortal. Denies them life, and they don't like it, so they kill me. So then that preserves the delusions, unfortunately. We're all the same, we're all delusions. I'm sad about my wife. She was in prison in Vienna somewhere. That's where she was, she wouldn't be there now. She may be transferred back to Budapest, which is where she would really the crime was committed, which is a pretty bad place to be. And so she could be. And it's difficult for me to do anything about it. So she won't be there for a long time. And I'm sad. I write a pleading letter asking for her to be released. I'm on compassionate grounds, basically. So she suffers so much as she should be. She was rather top of a profession in the communist era. Although she had been American as well, it was very confusing last year. But it was confusing. But it seems like she's thrown out of the bench. She was shooting people with the bus shooters from there, just for fun. Well, that's anyway, that's actually your offence, because when I say the person said, oh, obviously taking a love mark really doesn't solve the problem, it's revenge killing. And we're all animals, we all face this prospect of sudden death, all of us do, crossing the road, or the other bed, or dying of aneurysm, anyway, we all suffer from that chance of instant death. Starship wise, the same thing. Is it enough of a rock? No starship. That's how it is. And so, survival's on a knife edge all the time. And I eventually die. And the universe wins with me. In the on this planetary environment, it's no way to do. Some people die to degree, but they die. And they're vicious people. Animals are red in tooth and claw. It's true about it. And you talk to business people, you know, these. We run business, they say it's dog eats dog and it's actually awful. That's how they cut each other's throats. Not literally. And, you remove the opposition, that's their jungle war. And the idea of socialism is to make it sort of much better, but I think what we want is a free enterprise society with socialist laws of some sort to keep the system in check, which are communist laws. So that would help. A framework rather than the actual detail, which is what I've got in China. So within the system, I have free trade. And it's better. And it's also to do with relationship between people. When you go shopping, you actually make a relationship with the person in the shop. You're not just bartering for money. That's the tax. It's there. But if you make a relationship with the shop, you make an arrangement. That's fun. And in a lot of these countries, you can apple. You don't have to do it. The price fixing is rather unpleasant because it just goes up and up. So a cup of tea is very stressing. In this country, 80 pence, or usually 50 pence, it's about 80 pence. So it goes down though. Times of stress goes down. And so some cafes don't go up to get a good cup of tea at a low price. Posh cafes, which are expensive anyway, cost you £1.50 or more of a silver tray. Paper cup much cheaper. A tea very important. It's English, it's tea in America, it's particularly. But the price of things is variable. So capitalism is better because you can adapt, it's quite easy to adapt. But socialism have fixed prices. Your tea will cost one kopeck. A joke. And so it's always something won't get in tea at all because the bank can't produce it that much. But that's the problem. It doesn't really work. It's because it's a combined economy, charged with July. National service charged, doctors charged millions of pounds, do a few hours away, though, try to turn up between. And in the civil service, similar projects are held up by people wanting it to last to the end of their time to earn it. And the people run the ICR people have sat on them actually what it is from. Most of them just want a job, get a job for life, and if you produce anything, you have to produce a report, of course, so it looks as if you're working. That sort of thing. It's quite difficult to produce a report. I cut this thing here. I'm not skilled enough for a report, but I'll do it. I do a blog with the what I'll do it. It's just sort of thing, it's a blog. I can't do anything else. Well, I've got to have to be somewhere else, of course. They want to destroy me. And, the psychiatrist will take over your email addresses and all that stuff. So you appear to be alive when you're dead. That's the trouble. Well, I've tried to contact some of the people, my previous, but patients, or so-called patients. I'm not a patient really, but at all. It's a second narcissist, it really is. And I wouldn't be. And the other people, if I meet these people, my friends are rather dead, all dead. They're killing them all. And of course, they use a joke, but they're human beings too. And they can see a guilty dog in them, but they'll kill you. They don't want the money, I was told that Springfield, the death hill, is execution's a great expensive. But they destroy the brain after the gun. That's all your money. That's the way to extracting money. It's interesting. I was in this. It was actually a geriatric ward because I said I was 19, which is what I am, and I'm beginning to look like a 19 because it poisoned me, but it still poisoned me. I've already stepped out of 20. I could do it, Rose. I could do it. Well, I'm 30. I've got the can I have youth clothes, please? But no, it's not bad for me. The age is not important. You know, the legislation of this country is a certain age of that is there. It's been there for a long time. So if you don't fit in, they make you fit in. You know. Can't have you in forever. They might want it away. But that's the problem. The first one is slow beating heart. It is longer. The first one is a fast beating heart. So when I find a century, I speed it up. That kills them. And the normal person is actually quite plump. So they shoot as well as it's fat. Think of them fat. And fat people are reduced. So that's the idea of the normal. That is polymorphic, they're all different. I'm dying to death. It's serious death. Plus, we all die, so we're on it together, you know. And especially when a person's like, you throw them away. And then it's striking because the person who's dying probably has a disease. I mean, unless they're dying or something else, they could have a disease, infection. So if you don't get rid of them, throw them away. And I was interested in spirits when I asked those, when I got all down those, I sat on the wall and said, what are you doing? He said, well, I've got a heart disease. And the other detective never come down, I was saying, go away, we do, go on him, don't die here. So that's the attitude. And that was an eye opener. The attitude, I was like, my eyes is slightly different. Because if you have a person who's sick, you can go after them, and they'll be your friend. That's their reward. So, and that's my attitude. You'll get a friend, but I can't see that. They eat it, they throw it out because, by the way, so I didn't want to. It's killing me, it's complicated. I've got a friend, you see, which is why I put something thrown out. So that's what I found out. I'm going to kill me. And it's basically physical killing. There's a pretty good reason for it. It's not a result there. We don't do it all else. We'll give everything we should kill. That's the problem. So, I'm not happy. And it has this guilty smile on them. Smile of a killer fox. If they're a wolf with its fang, they can see it. I can see your fang. So, yeah, the man makes the same expression as the fox. Well, a wolf when it kills you. But I live with wolves, so they're similar. And, it's a similar side. It's slightly more generous than a fox and an animal. We're animals too. And the killer, the smile on the face. Killer. And a healthy wolf is a killer wolf. Okay? So it won't be friendly, but it isn't really. It's a killer wolf. And that applies to people too. And you go on to this place and it's attractive if you have wolf wishes there. And what do you think? You're a killer wolf, aren't you? Is it healthy? Sure, I can see it. I can see that the expression of the eyes is the same as a wolf when it's gonna kill. That's the same to you, like, but with man, they tend to steal your money rather than kill you. And, they just stole all the money, so I've got it. They excuse me, house, you know, put me out, throw me away. That's the attitude, which is, well, that's true of any society. The old people are squeezed out. If I'm making a contribution, I'll say, this machine is a contribution. I'm not quite ill. They've already poisoned me, so maybe. Destroy my brain and put it in there. I've been poisoned all the time. That's how sensitive what they do. How sensitive to me. Don't like me. Somebody doesn't like me. And most of them in this country get their brains bashed in. They smash, either bash them on the head or they put a knife in to get them to work in a factory somewhere. I find factory work is awful, really. It's like the satanic mills, which is talked about, which is still there. And it's upstairs, downside society. You get the workers who have a downstairs or down floor with their sandwiches. they like to go. They can go to restaurants, and there's a lot of restaurants who say quite good food. But it's not only do the encouraging just to starve workers, they're going to be hungry, but not starving. And then the executive guys are all up, also being in their own rich. And they have sort of fish and stuff, which is very, very bony, all stuff. Although it's just fish, as long as it's cooked, it's very nice. But some societies, like decanomatates, they do give good food to the workers as well. So I don't know what you guys are later at the shrimp or some caviar or mushrooms. So that's a joke, but that's how it is. So our society is. And it's been like that for a long time. I would like to have a society of equals, you know, people having the same sort of opportunities that was there's a diversity, and they also same sort of wealthy value with the same opportunities to do things and have things, you know, because it goes the same. When you do things, you have things. I'm pointing out, I want to do something like doing now or something else, and there was that, I mean, tools that I need, money for tools. They want what they want me to do, so I used to work doing shopping one thing on one side of the day, or maybe a week, and then the rest of the week doing something else. It's also difficult. And I'm pointing that. And most workers who work in a factory, which is usually just one operation with the left arm, but two arms, donk, 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 and that's what a man does. But that's not a human activity. It's what people do, but it's not human, really. And it's ignoring the animals, things like that. And I've seen it, you know, some factory workers. And they actually wanted me to have a charger, to a charger for. What if they break their arm? The problem is, for instance, those machines are gone now, it's all done by mirrors now, done by machine. And all the patches are rushed here, so I can see it. Which actually isn't there. All the patches need people to keep machines going and buy the machines orders, and that's worse. People don't like machines, and they don't like machines in education. But there's no particular reason why I don't like it, they just don't like it. Because it's dangerous. We don't like it because there's man playing God, and they look at me, you know. And because I don't know much about DNA, I was trying to go on a training course of DNA extraction, but I was unable to guide it because people didn't want me to, you know. They thought DNA was something very, very chemical about a plant. And I read the instructions for a good deal. Chemistry is just chemistry, and that's what it was to me. But to some people, it's very important, because that's what life is based on, that living things contain it. But it needs the rest of it, so the rest of it, of the cell to work. It's a DNA will die. It's not alive. DNA is just life, it's just stuff. Yellow or one pad which will die and which will disappear. Good thing. There's no worry about. So you get still, maybe it infects you, but maybe it affects your body. But it won't be that idea. But it does happen. Yeah. So maybe sometimes, the implant goes wrong and the baby starts, but it doesn't mean you've got a teeth or something, or legs. So it's not nice. And can happen. And the semen is also implanted with him, so the organs that handle it is fertilized in some way. It's a very bad world. And we all die. So. Virus is wonderful, but it's just chance events, very complicated, there's a chance of it. And in all our lives are like that, it's all chance events. And all our lives are unlikely, everything we do is unlikely, you know. So I think the normal life is no such thing. We're all unlikely. You meet someone in the street, how likely is that? We meet all the time. But it's very unlikely if you meet a particular person, we always meet people. Every meeting is unlikely. But you will have a meeting. And if you're out there dinner, it's a sort of meeting, I'll be still. And then it's wonderful. Because you've got support. And so on, so. People die. Socrates did have his opportunity not to take his poison when he started taking it. He was actually doing it because he said people were not immortals, they didn't like it, so poisoned them. And he reasoned to himself, well, you then might as well take the immunities. I don't need them. That's the sort of way he was. I lost Socrates. And, but he thought the Boa Sapiens was bad and wise. Homo means man, you see, well, quite a lot of homos around. Man and wise is that's common. And some man and wise are wiser than others. And I've criticised black people, I don't like it, you know. And I said there are some species that aren't exactly human beings, but that's a very unpleasant thing. But I've said my mind now, we actually were all outbeat now. Evolution carries on. And, once you adapt to it, it's better than where you are. They call it something. My head goes up twice as long as it was, pretty much long eggs and round is, but I don't know. And they're dangerous, because big eggs are dangerous. And, well, they'll get rid of me. I think they want to get rid of me. I've seen this big headed person running about, so he don't want to get rid of me. He was injectionless, you know, maybe not. But the law of published the rights, of course, it kills you. Wonderful. Let's give one painful death. That's what it is. And so I discussed what I thought, and I found what I thought was not right. But it's not a nice world. And, what I said to them already, somebody knocking in the chest, so you hit me hard. You believe it. Because you touch the heart, it doesn't work very well. I find these bottles of water are very helpful in keeping you alive, which is nice to be alive. Because the alternative is not terrible. I've got a picture in front of me of me taken a long time ago when I was awarded, was it to do with my pediatric side, because I haven't paid anything, that's how I'm there. But it's the same, I look the same, and I've got about a same amount of hair then. It's a miserable part, it's strange. You know, when I wanted to retire, Ross said, your hair isn't white, you know. Because I thought they dejected me to make it white, you know, wonderful, wasn't painted white. And I just remember when I was such an age, I decided to ask Tony haircut people, barbers, to put a dye on to darken it and also to add some hair to it. So they thought I wasn't saying it was truthful, in fact, I agreed to it, barbers. So that's nice. And that's why it fell out. Well, it's because it wasn't renewed, so it wasn't there at all. Just sprayed on him. So it's a joke. And the doctors are so stupid, they can't see where they're going. But these injections, they destroy my hair. They're very old. The skin and age is awful. But I wanted to go on anyway, so it can't make a difference. So you can't tell. They got some idea of keeping me prisoner until I was 71, which I said I was in the first place. Big deal. So I'm no older. I think I'm 72 now. My birth, it makes me about 92, which is quite old. And of course, when you're old, you expect to fade away. And being poisoned doesn't help. If they hadn't poisoned me, there's no guarantee that I wouldn't have got old. I would have died. And they didn't like people who live forever. Well, I wouldn't have lived forever. They poisoned me, it's not nice. And they just hold my brains back. Yes. And they say, now say, scatter off, and I didn't. I'm not quite sure where I was, but I was being knocked in, and I saw the others were brain dead, so I thought they'd better get out before I'm brain dead. And they're still killing me, still poisoning me, so I think they tested whether the water was down on the street because of it. So you've written as closely as rocks is not, it's the same state. Right, the half of the aristocracy. What I'm buying, that's what I'm and these are these factors, Chris. So how you go with a knife when they are. That's what it is. Don't like me, you know, I'll get you old now, dying in your cemetery. They're poisoning me, I'll save you the old. I thought, oh, what it is, they're poisoning me, they'll give injections, aging injections, you know. Anti-aging injections would be better. But the psychiatrist is doing it. It's the person I saw burning people on night. I took a photo of that. That's what I mean. And so these psychiatrists are actually death camps, you know. All the psychiatrists are actually death camps. I don't know, I just wake up dead, you know, it's not good. But, what sounds of strategy of sentences? I'm getting the same sort of bit myself here. Next thing they do, they shoot you. Don't need you anymore. Socialism is like that. And Uncle Arthur used to say that socialism, from the cradle to the grave. He was brain damaged, yeah, later, but now put through it, and he had an impression of his brain went to it out. But that's how bad it is. And of course, he knew, and he knew that he'd been done out of his life, so he just said, that's what it meant. It was done through national service, and you know, because if somebody wants to do it to a doctor, wants to do it to you privately, he has to pay. That's his intent. He was taking out insurance. Against being attacked, that makes a difference. So, you show yourself, I was told, because before this happened, I was a child and I had a good job with millions of pounds, I didn't know what it was, and I was told to insure my face. I really didn't understand it, and if I had it done, I would have been safe. I didn't know that. So, besides this, pay me, or he gets it, so that's amazing. So that was all, it was just money. You pay me, I'll smash your face. And that's universal cheating. I knew that, I didn't know that at the time. I didn't really understand it. It's a mistake, of course. Children make mistakes, or adults do it too. And so I got things done to me. And it's actually, the person who did it was actually a judge. He must have been hired to get rid of me. But it's still my life divorce, though I managed to hit, so it's actually managed to hit that. Which I didn't know about. And anyway, I think my mother found me actually after a German air raid. And I was, as I remember, I was actually shot down. And because there was no food, I shrank to a child. And I didn't realise what had happened. I don't know if they found me, I think they didn't find me. But I was shrunk out of a bomb. And well, I was sad, I couldn't stand up, and I floated a bit, and couldn't put them on, so it was a joke. So I was caught and I was picked up. And then, of course, I thought I was a child, because I wasn't. And it was, that's what happened. Apparently, I was a child with the wisdom and knowledge of a man. And and of course, I was a German soldier anyway, so it's what we must make. And I was straight out here as well, so I managed to find a place which I wasn't there, and I've actually forgotten it eventually. And when somebody asked me a question, I would have answered straight away. Well, I can't do that because I'm on radio, they can't believe me here. And of course, I am a bit dozy now. So, that's So it takes quite a long time to answer a question, but I have to send it up to the receiver, and that's actually quite a complicated system of satellites, and then it goes on to a place where basically the machine will work out what to say, and it sends you back. And then once that's done, I'll get a packet which keeps me up to date with the information. It's just, that's how they answer. If they keep asking questions of different subjects, I can't do it, because each one takes a download. And it's got a long time to download data, especially it comes from the way. I think the nearest place is the moon, but I have to suppose it's actually further away than that. The moon is actually quite dangerous for us to be, because these rockets that keep sending you, it's quite dangerous. Well, hit me. And they say, why can't you go to people who say you've got something? Well, of course you can't, you're far away. And